Get ready to match the stars from the Bob Newhart Show, Bill Daly, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Riley, Elaine Jones, from Family Feud, Richard Dawson, and from the Mary Tyler Moore Show, Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game, BM! And now, here's the star of Match Game, BM, Gene Rayburn!
Thank you very much, Daniel. Thank you for joining us. What do you say we get right to it?
Yeah.
Let's not fool around, right? All right. Let's say hello to Valerie Allen and Brian Sykes here. Yeah. Before we start playing our game, we'd like to find out a little bit about each of you, and Brian, we'll begin with you. Tell us where you're from and what you do for a living and all that.
I'm Brian Seitz. I'm from Los Angeles. Born and raised here, lived here 34 years. I'm a waiter, a photographer. I have two dogs, and they don't have any children.
Okay. What kind of dogs you got? Forget it, Brian. I don't want to tax you. Okay. Valerie? Where are you from?
Well, I am from Greenspot, which is a suburb of Redlands, and it's off Highway 38 on the way to Big Bear.
Uh-huh.
And we have a 5-acre ranch where we raise and show Arabian horses.
Arabian horses, the best.
And I'm a part-time model, and I also work at a department store in Redlands. And I'm hoped to become an airline stewardess, and I go for my final interview next week. So I'm hoping.
Well, you're past as far as I'm concerned, and you sound like a very busy lady. Good luck to both of you. Listen, I just want to point out that here on Match Game PM, each of you will have three chances to match as many of our celebrities as you possibly can. And the one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner. Go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $10,000. Now, there we go. Around one questions. Brian, you may have A or B?
A.
You want A. Okay, here we go. George said...
Yeah?
He says, things sure change fast in Washington, D.C. I checked into my hotel room and was I surprised. My bags were carried by blank. I'll read it to you one more time.
No, I've got it, honey. I don't need it.
George said, things sure change fast in Washington, D.C. I checked into my hotel room, and was I surprised. My bags were carried by blank.
That's finished.
Your last chance.
I'm finished.
I don't know what that is.
All right, now, Brian, come to you. George said, things sure change fast in Washington, D.C. Well, I checked into my hotel room, and was I surprised. My bags were carried by...
Richard Nixon.
Richard Nixon, he said. Okay. Isn't that a pretty good answer?
Yeah, that's a good answer. I'm starting off very nicely with this group. I said a very old bellhop. Sorry about
that. Yeah. You just didn't get the idea.
I didn't get the idea of that at all.
Well, Brian got the idea right off the bat there. Yeah. What do you say?
I say let's get rid of him as quickly as we can.
We're stuck
with
him.
Oh, I love him. I know I have to. Oh, I don't know what we're going to do. Now... Fast was the operative word, right?
Change.
Fast. I said Mr. Ford.
Mr. Ford. Okay. Yes, Charles.
Look at me stunned, Charles.
She tried to tell us in the green room that this thing that she's wearing was by a very well-known designer. And I said, where is his name in it? And she said, I took it out. I know the designer. He wouldn't be 10 feet in that. It looks like a dentist hygiene thing going wrong. I said, who, what president carries bags?
Jimmy Carter.
I said, President Carter's carrying bags.
Okay, that's another good possibility. All right, Brian said, Richard Nixon. What do you say, Elaine?
Well, I figured it was somebody who had a lot of experience traveling and carrying a lot of bags around, right? So the one I could think of, that's wrong. You're right. I said Kissinger.
No. Now, wait a minute. That's another good answer.
Oh, thank you, Gene.
That's one of the possibilities.
So much do you want to keep
Nixon,
this?
Carter, Nixon, Ford, all those. Yes, I'll keep that forever as a memento.
You don't have to.
All right.
Richard will keep it.
Show and tell.
I was going to say Helen of Troy, but I said...
She's doing a lot of traveling.
Yeah.
We know what you mean.
But I said, what is that? Jerry Ford.
Jerry Ford.
I said President Good.
Okay, Carrie's bad. Valerie, are you ready?
Yeah.
All right, now listen carefully. 1B, okay, yeah. You got it. George said, my mother-in-law is the last...
Another George?
What?
Another George? I'm very bad with Georges. Don't say
George. Change the name.
Change the name to George. Give me a
Larry.
Or something.
George.
Sam said.
Yeah. Now we'll get letters.
I don't care, Sam. I don't care how many letters you write to me. Sam said, my mother-in-law is the last of a vanishing species. She looks like a blank. All right. You ready, Valerie?
Ready.
They're all ready. George said, my mother-in-law is the last of a vanishing species. She looks like a blank.
A bald eagle.
A bald eagle.
Yeah.
Very imaginative answer. Unfortunately, that species is diminishing.
Yes.
What do you say?
I'm not even close. She looks like an old bellhop. No, an old alligator. That's not
old right. Alligator.
Alligators are. Come on. No.
Are they? Yeah, I don't know. Brett?
Too bad. Right?
That's two for you, Bill.
Too bad. He's, okay.
What do you say?
Well, Phyllis Diller had one of these coats, and I said I'd take it off her cheap, but she refused to sell it to me. Leopard.
Whoop. Looks like a leopard. A
That's
vanishing
a vanishing species.
Species.
That
was
so
bad you didn't get a boo on it.
What do you say?
I said, the lovely white whale.
Well, the only thing wrong with that, Charles, is that all white whales are lovely. Hello, Elaine.
Hello, darling.
My mother-in-law is the last of a vanishing species. She looks like a bald eagle, according to Valerie.
I said Republican.
Yeah.
Unfortunately.
Yes, they are in diminuendo, aren't they? What did you say, Richard?
I'm shocked to hear about the alligators, Bill. I said bald eagle.
Thank you, Valerie.
Marty.
Looking for a bald eagle.
I've been looking for one and found a couple in my time. But the thing is, Zane Grey called him the vanishing herd, the buffalo.
Oh, yeah.
Ah,
that's right. Okay.
What can I tell you?
There we are at the end of round one. 1-0 in favor of Valerie. Round two coming up right after these messages. Now, we'll go to round two. Valerie, you're ahead, so we'll ask you to go first. You may have A or B.
A.
You want A? Okay.
A.
Ready?
Wait. Seriously, have you seen any alligators around, like, this morning?
Oh,
no.
Yeah.
No.
I mean, that's...
They are vanishing.
It.
Yeah.
What do you mean?
Yes.
What was that joke? I'm sorry I brought that up. I'll vanish after
that. It was the thundering heard by Zane Grey.
This is turning me off. Elliot said, my wife, the bus driver, talks in her sleep. Last night, she kept telling me to blank.
Got it! Oh.
Very good. You've caught on quickly, my dear.
Isn't it wonderful?
Next week, we're going to do numbers, 1 to 8.
No.
Okay, Valerie. Elliot said, my wife, the bus driver, talks in her sleep. Last night, she kept telling me to blank.
Stop.
Stop. Okay. Stop. Stop.
Stop.
What did you say?
I said, get to the rear of the bed.
How about you?
I said, get off.
Oh. Yes.
White whale, is this the white whale question?
No.
I said, fair please.
Fair please. Okay.
The gum helped it.
Elliot said, my wife, the bus driver, talks in her sleep, and last night she kept telling me to blink. What do you say to that?
She kept telling him to step to the rear.
Step to the rear. And you, Ms. Betty, honey?
Go to the back.
Okay. So there we are. Now, Brian, are you ready for yours? Here we go. The archaeologist said... This is the most unusual find ever. Look, this mummy was buried. The archaeologist said, this is the most unusual find ever.
Uh,
This mummy was buried holding her blank. Good. All right. They're all right. Here we go, Brian. The archaeologist said, this is the most unusual find ever. Look, this mummy was buried holding her blank.
Bones.
Holding her bones. Yes. Holding her bones.
Holding her bones.
Yes. It could have been much worse. What do you say?
I say, holding her breath, and that's how she got there. I say,
you know, holding her breath. That's good. I like that one. That's very good. What do you say?
I was going to say holding a horse, but I figured that that was not that. I said holding her eight children.
Holding her eight children. A fertile mummy.
You know what that comes from? That comes from those rotten kids always saying, where are you going? I want to go with you. She said, come on. All the mothers.
Every mother understands, right.
Sure. That wasn't bad.
Yes.
Wow. Good luck. That's wonderful. I said the same as Mr. Daly. I said breath, but that meant that she was still alive and she was
4,321 years old.
And they found out she was a Pisces.
A Pisces.
Okay.
What has happened to Charles?
The archaeologist said this is the most unusual find ever. This mummy was buried holding her...
Oh, I'm so repetitive. Breath.
Breath. Yes.
Just well, that would make...
I almost said that.
Breath.
I said boobs.
Boobs. Yes.
Mummy and baby doing well.
Mummy and baby doing well. Holding her baby. Okay, so there we are. Now we go to round three. Valerie, you're still ahead. We're going to ask you to go first. You may have A or B.
Close game. B.
B? Okay, 1-0 the score. As you can see, very tight game. Two good players here. Oh, Sam the sculptor said.
Change it to George.
George the sculptor said, in order to make great art, an artist has to suffer.
Yeah.
And that's why I'm sitting on my blank. In order to make great art, an artist has to suffer, and that's why I'm sitting on my blank.
Well, now. Okay. I'm not too crazy about that question, I don't think.
That's a good question.
Is it?
Perfectly good question.
Oh, okay. I'm just checking.
Okay, here we go. Valerie. Sam the sculptor said, in order to make great art, an artist has to suffer, and that's why I'm sitting on my...
The clay, or the stuff you make sculpture stuff out of. You know... Well, it's the... What do they make it out of? Well, clay? Is it clay?
Well, clay is going to be your answer.
Okay.
But there are other materials they work in. Bronze, marble... You see all that?
Organdy.
Organdy.
Some no, not sculptures, honey.
What do you say?
What do you say? How's it going?
Oh,
what are you doing these days?
Not much.
Yeah, nice talking.
Trying to get by.
I said, this doesn't make it. Sitting on his buns. That's comfortable.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, I told you that I wasn't too sure about what this question meant. So I said, sitting on my bed of nails.
All right. He would suffer. Charles?
In keeping with these wonderful answers, I said hot stove.
Yeah. Well, now, Valerie was really on the right track. Something to do with his art.
Right.
Like what?
Like he sat on his chisel.
That's good.
Chisel would hurt more than the clay, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. What'd you say?
Chisel.
Righto. Yeah, the chisel would hurt a little more than clay, I guess. So there we are. Now, Brian, great intellect that you are, I point out to you the score is 1-0, and it's 1-tie and 2-win. Ralph said, Ralph, here's old Ralph said,
Ralph.
When I was a kid, we were so poor, the only way we could get milk was to mug a blank. That's how poor we were.
Oh, God,
simple.
Simple.
Right. Okay, here we go.
Dig it in, honey.
Come on, Charles. Ralph said, when I was a kid, we were so poor, the only way we could get milk was to mug a blank.
Milkman.
A milkman. All right. Milkman was one of the two good choices there. What do you say?
Well, I've got one of the bad of the two choices. I got a cow. Milk a cow.
Cow is good. Mug a cow is all right. Don't be ashamed of that at all.
Isn't that the best answer he's given? Golly knows, I can't remember when. Cow.
Cow. And you?
In keeping with a cow.
Cow. Three cows up there. Funny, I thought that would score
that.
What? Oh, yeah, three cows up there.
And one cow.
Huh?
What do you say?
The whole herd. Cow.
Oh, dear. I thought a lot more would say cow.
Cow.
Milkman. Now, you've got to match Betty to stay in the game and achieve a tie. He's looking for milkman.
I was torn between two, camel and cow.
Well, Andy Valerie wins the game. Come on now, Valerie. Okay. You hang around there for a moment or so. We're going to say goodbye to Brian Sykes here. Pleasure meeting you.
Thank you very much.
A very courageous man. And I wish you the best of luck. We're going to have a lot of gifts for you coming your way. There goes Brian Sykes. I'm always spinning him off. He's sending messages for you. Then hurry back, see how she does. Here we go.
Stop smoking,
this lady
right?
has won the game, and she's got a chance to win a big bundle of money here. And to do this, we've got two audience matches for you here. And what I point out to you now is that whatever you win in these audience matches, you'll have a chance to multiply by 10. That'll be the final dollar amount you'll be playing for. You ready? Here we go. We polled a recent studio audience, got their best response to this. Octo blank.
What?
Octo. O-C-T-O blank. Now, the answer they gave most frequently will get you $500, Valerie, if you match it. $250 for matching the second most popular answer and $100 for the third. And you may call on three of our six celebrities for help.
Richard.
Octopus.
Octopus is one.
Betty.
Betty.
Octogenarian.
Yes.
Good. Eddie Lane.
Burr.
October. All right. So you've got October, octogenarian, and octopus. Now, you can choose one of those, or if you've got a better idea in your head, give us that one.
Octopus.
You want the octopus. All right, that's the one that Richard gave you. Let's find out if it's up there. May we see the $100 number? Octagon. No,
octagon.
That's it. No plugs, please.
That's what I should have done. I octagon.
That's the way, yes. Octopus is what we want. May we see the $250 number? October.
Yay!
There's Elaine's answer. And last chance here for Octopus. Slide it, Earl. Yes, you got it. Very good. You won $500. That means the least you'll be playing for is 10 times that amount or $5,000. Okay. Now we're going to see how much more you'll win with your second audience match. Here we go. Ernest Blank. All right, sing out.
Richard.
Hemingway.
Okay, one.
Charles.
Ernest Borgnine.
What was that man who had all that terrible trouble? Ernest Butts? Was that his name or Boot?
No, that was Earl Butts.
Oh!
There is no Ernest Butts. Oh, dear me.
Ernestine.
Okay, I remember him. Anyway, you got Ernestine, Ernest Borgnine, and Ernest Hemingway. You want one of those? Did anything else occur to you?
No. Hemingway.
You want Hemingway. All right, let's go over Hemingway. Let's go up there and reveal the $100 response. Ernest Tubbs.
That's who I meant.
That's who you meant, sure.
Who is Ernest Tubbs?
Now you say it. Hemingway, are you on the $250 number? Borgnine is there. Now let's see who's hiding under the $500 number.
Ernest.
Okay, got it. Now, another $500 multiplied by 10, another $5,000 added to the previous $5,000. You got a pot of $10,000 to shoot for, and we want you to have that money. We want to give it to you, but you got to match one celebrity.
Richard.
Okay, good luck to you. Get your ESP flowing over to him. Get your thoughts in tune there. It's worth $10,000. Good luck to you. Here it is. Blank Dream. D-R-E-A-M.
Perfect.
Okay, now Valerie, we want you to give us an answer which you think will match his, and if you do that, you get the $10,000. Blank dream.
Sweet dream?
Sweet dream. That usually says sweet dreams. It's pluralized, but we'll figure out right now whether you get the money or not by asking Richard to show us his answer.
There were many.
There were?
Daydream.
Daydream.
American dream. I said pipe dreams.
Pipe dream is a good one. Yeah.
I thought with Arabian horses. I thought that might...
Pipe dream.
Yeah.
Okay, Valerie, you've picked up a total of $1,000 here. We congratulate you for that. We'll be along in a moment or so. Hurry right back. Join us next week for Match Game PM. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive Mr. Coffee, the revolutionary... And Bardol's new fuel system treatment, the gasoline additive to help keep your entire fuel system clean from gas tank to carburetor. You'll feel the difference. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Woodson, Bill Trotman production.